Welcome back. John Kerry begins his first visit to India as Secretary of State this week. And while the official line is that Mr. Kerry will be here to add more energy to the Indo-US strategic relationship, the reality is that Mr. Kerry and his team would be looking for more business deals with India.
It's his first visit to India after taking over the highest post in the US State Department. But unlike his predecessor Hillary Clinton, John Kerry is going to keep it short, confining his visit to the capital. The US Secretary of State is coming straight from Doha, where the Taliban has formally opened an office. India's top focus: the security situation in Afghanistan post-2014 and terror emanating from Pakistan.
We've worked very hard on preparing for the visit from both sides, and we will obviously give some priority, but there'll be a wide range of subjects, both of bilateral interest as indeed of multilateral concern.
India's relationship with US had taken a hit after the 2008 Civil Nuclear Cooperation Agreement was stalled.
There has been a feeling that they're at a standstill, but that's because both countries are so preoccupied with, we are preoccupied with our home affairs, so are they, and many other issues. But I think it is a sign that they want to look at the long-term interests, which do coincide in many ways, and therefore they want to, as you say, give it a boost.
But John Kerry making an earnest attempt to iron out differences between the two countries even before setting foot in New Delhi, welcoming India as a rising power and openly supporting India's inclusion as a permanent member of the UNSC.
The United States not only welcomes India as a rising power, we fervently support it. And that's why President Obama and I support India's inclusion as a member, a permanent member, of a reformed and expanded United Nations Security Council.
While US is trying to have a greater foothold in India, be it soft power projects or expectations of huge defense deals, India in return may want its pound of flesh in the form of cooperation to counter China's assertiveness. America is coming to India with a wish list, and New Delhi is for once prepared to deal with US. Both sides will discuss issues of regional security, economic engagement, defense and nuclear cooperation. While New Delhi and Washington have made a headway in the strategic realm, what's important for India is America's policy with the new Pakistani government and whether they will cooperate in giving India's long-standing demand of getting access to terrorists like David Headley and Tahawwur Rana.
To show the importance that he places on India-US relations, Secretary of State John Kerry has chosen to visit only India and deferred his visit to Pakistan. And to understand what India can expect from the visit of John Kerry, we have with us Professor Stephen Cohen, a long-standing observer of this part of the world and the author of many well-recognized volumes on India and Pakistan, and currently a senior fellow at Brookings Institution in Washington, D.C. Professor Cohen, in 2004, Prime Minister Vajpayee described India and the US as natural allies. And then President Bush went on to describe the two countries as strategic allies. But it gives us the impression now that the Obama administration is not so enthusiastic about relations between New Delhi and Washington. Why is that so?
Now, I'd say that the Obama administration is so busy with crises elsewhere that South Asia has been neglected. And also, South Asia isn't an area of crisis right now. And the senior leadership in the State Department at the White House tend to go where the crises are. So I'm not worried about this at all. I think it's a much, much improved relationship over 5 years ago, over 10 years ago, and 20, 30 years ago when I first went to India, 50 years ago. It's totally transformed. So I think our relationship with India is about that with the major European countries, perhaps France. We have agreements. We also have some disagreements.
Okay, there's a lot of talk about the next steps in strategic partnership, and these were put in place in 2004 that called for sharing of dual-use technologies in missile defense, civil nuclear issues, and space cooperation. How much has been achieved, and what really could be on Kerry's agenda?
Well, the enthusiasm for the relationship on the American side tapered off because the Indians could not provide the conclusion to the nuclear deal because of the liability laws. On the other hand, India wants to buy natural gas from the United States, and we're thinking whether to sell it to India. We're going to become a major natural gas producer. So I see a possibility in the future. I'm not sure if they're going to talk about it at this meeting, for trade-off between India's nuclear openness and America's sale of natural gas to India on a long-term basis. I think there's ways of doing this, but I'm not sure if this is the time and place for these issues to be discussed, because there's going to be a new government in India.
Officially, Kerry seems to be coming here to add new life to the next steps in strategic partnership, but many American companies want to push for more trade with India, particularly defense contracts and the acceptance of U.S. pharmaceutical patent laws by Indian companies and things of such nature. So do you think this visit is going to be more about strategic issues or business issues?
Well, I think the important lesson from this visit, and I think the past visit also, is that strategy now includes economics. The world has become demilitarized in the sense that large-scale conflict is inconceivable between India and its neighbors, or between the U.S. and, say, Russia. I think so economic issues float to the top, and a lot of these strategic dialogues are about economic issues. The Indians, for example, want things from the United States besides natural gas. They would like to see a term of an American visa regime for Indians coming to the U.S. and for Indian companies doing business in the U.S. So I think there's room here for bargaining and trade-offs. I think that it's normal diplomacy as far as I see it. Well, the issues arise in the long-term relationship with China on the one hand and with Pakistan on the other.
Pakistan is certainly, an ally that brings more trouble to America than good news. And this new relationship between Beijing and Washington is obviously going to be redefining world politics. And India seems to be standing on the margins now, as it were.
Yeah, in the new book I've just published, it's going to be published in India shortly, I make the comment that Pakistan is an ally but not necessarily a friend. India is a friend but not necessarily an ally. We're dependent on Pakistan for certain things, especially Afghanistan related, but I think we're also concerned, as is India, about the future of Pakistan, that it be a stable, normal state. So I think our interests in Pakistan are not diminished, but our interests in China are more long-term than our concerns with Pakistan. India, of course, is a neighbor of both. So on these issues, I think we should have some conversation with New Delhi. But I'm not sure Kerry's going to bring these up at this point. We've got a lot of other short-term issues to worry about, especially the American withdrawal from Afghanistan.
So what kind of partnership could India expect from America, or America could expect India to deliver in terms of a long-term strategic relationship? India certainly is not keen to play second fiddle to America.
Well, many Americans would like to see India play a more activist role in international diplomacy outside of its region, especially with Iran and perhaps in other areas. I'm skeptical of that view. I think that India has its handful in managing its own domestic politics and in trying to pursue normal relations with Pakistan and, of course, the occasional crisis with China. So I think American pressure on India to be more activist is probably unwise. On the other hand, the Indians can't expect too much from the nuclear deal. You know, in a sense, these things operate on a quid pro quo basis. While we do regard India more as a more important country than we have in the past, Indians themselves have to be more activist. And I think also have to reorganize the way in which they approach diplomacy and strategy to be a more effective player.
Well, thank you, Professor Cohen. It's interesting that you bring out that India, though not a strategic ally of the U.S., is certainly a friend. And whereas Pakistan has for years been labeled as U.S.'s non-NATO military ally, is anything but a friend. More importantly, there is now a recognition in Washington that if America is to achieve its stated goals in this part of the world, it certainly needs India's assistance. Thank you for watching this episode of Latitude, and until our next episode, goodbye and thank you.